everybody. Welcome to Transformational Tuesdays. My name is Patty Tucker, and I am a transformational guide here at Astrology Answers. Every Tuesday, I get to check in with all of you and just share with you some of the things that I've learned along the way on my own personal journey. As well, I get to share with you what's kind of happening, you know, astrologically speaking, energetically speaking, and I always like to start off with a quote. So without further ado, I do want to welcome any new people to this Transformational Tuesday and to our Transformational Tribe. And you guys are always really great at sending me hearts, and I really enjoy that. I totally believe that with a lot of kindness and love, we can go a long way in life, and it's pretty simple, isn't it? So without further ado, let's talk about this quote. And it has to do with the moon. The supermoon that we're going to be experiencing at the end of the month, which I'm really excited about. And it is that we are moving towards a light that embraces the darkness. Isn't that incredible? The full moon is all about light. It's about that extra light. And a lot of us don't know what that full moon really does. Last week, Kenesha Bell wrote in that she is a Pisces, and she wants to know, how does a full moon affect her Pisces nature? Well, Kenesha, here's the deal. Being a Pisces, you're a water sign. Also, the moon is all about emotions, and emotions belong to the quadrant of the soul, which is water. So the water is the element that relates to emotions. So when there's a full moon in your life, Kenesha, being a Pisces, you get a double whammy. And this month, we have a trifecta because we have a super blue moon, which we're going to talk about in a minute. So, Kenesha, here's my best advice. And to all of you, because I do this daily, I always look at what emotion is arising in my life. Because here's what I find. That darkness is really about what exists in the subconscious mind. It's that stuff that we're really not aware of. So when we bring awareness into the game, which is light, it's another way of saying I'm bringing light in, because awareness is light, right? We illuminate that which we're unaware of. So the full moon is all about that. It illuminates and intensifies what we're feeling. So let's together use the power of the moon, this full moon, this super blue moon, to look at what emotions may be in the darkness. You could be feeling angry, but shoving it down. You could be feeling sad, lonely, rejected, abandoned. I mean, the list goes on, does it not? But when we stop having a problem with our emotions, and we allow them to be there, and we allow them to do what they need to do, right, guys? To emotion, energy in motion. So let's let whatever that most predominant emotion is to just flow through, and then let's use this super moon to really bring that forward. The moon does four things, and this is really, really important. You want to remember this, so maybe you want to write it down, okay? So the full moon, first and foremost, intensifies feelings. So just asking yourself as this super moon, full moon approaches, what am I feeling? And write it down. Go get yourself a moon journal and write these things down, because you get to do a ceremony and get rid of them. That's what the full moon is for. It allows you to look at what is surfacing, illuminate it, and then let go. Okay? It also magnifies the emotions. So oftentimes we hear people say, oh, she's acting crazy, or, you know, we hear about the wolf howling at the moon. It's about letting that emotion out. So the full moon will magnify the emotion so that you can bring it to the light of the full moon. The full moon can also energize you. This is a big one for me. I cannot sleep around the full moon. So I've stopped having trouble with it. And what I do is I bring my full moon journal out. It's always at my bedside. And I look at what is trying to come up. And typically it comes through the subconscious, the unconscious, where the dark stuff lies. We don't know it's there. So if we're not sleeping, it's typically because our soul wants to inform us of that which needs to be brought to the light, to our awareness, okay? The full moon also illuminates what needs to go to the light. So we, again, need to bring that energy of the full moon to the awareness and the realization that oftentimes that what is lying dormant or unknown to us will be considered to be density or darkness sooner or later, and that we do have to become aware enough to release it. So if this is making sense thus far, you guys, give me a thumbs up. Love the hearts. Would love you to check in and let me know how the full moon affects you. I'm going to give you some tools for the full moon. As we approach the 31st of January, I want you to really try to get present. And we talk a lot about this here on Transformational Tuesdays. How do we get present? We bring our breath. We use our breath to just bring us to the moment. We use our breath to bring us and anchor us in the present moment, because it's in the present moment where we become more mindful and not full of mind, okay? And we become more productive. We become less stressful. And over time, by bringing and using our breath to bring us to the present moment, to ground us into the present moment, we become more productive. We become more accessible to our essence, which is light, which is love, which is a higher energy. So again, just using our breath, being aware. So I call this my ABCs, and I've shared this with you before, and I'm going to remind you, because it's a game changer, and here we like to transform, we like to make changes. So A, awareness. B, breath. C, choice. We make a different choice when we're more present. We're less reactive and more proactive. Okay? So, what is a super blue moon? Well, what is a blue moon is two full moons in 1 month. This month we have our next full moon, January 31st, in Leo. So you Leos, myself included, this is going to be interesting, because you're all about the personality, which is the sun. Now you've got this blue moon, so be very aware. You might have some very deep, dark emotions that will want to come up to surface to be released by the full moon, okay? What makes it super is we have a lunar eclipse. I don't think this has happened for like 121 years. So you guys, this is really, really auspicious, which means it's really good stuff, okay? Lunar eclipse is when the moon passes directly behind the Earth. This can only occur when the sun, moon, and Earth are aligned precisely. So this is really, really valuable. So let's bring that energy into releasing those emotions that can oftentimes control us because we don't know they're in the background, in the unconscious. So we're going to use this full moon to bring light and those dark emotions forward. Okay? Thanks for the hearts, you guys. I want to check in now. I've got Dee, who's a Pisces. Welcome, Dee. So you too are a water sign, so you're going to find that these moon periods for you are going to have quite an effect. Orvin is Scorpio. Scorpio, you're a fire sign. So the moon can be very interesting for you because you're going to have the sun opposite the moon, right? So be aware, be very aware. Don't have a problem with that the anger is there. The anger is just there. With your awareness and attention and self-care, it can be released, okay? Because really, our emotions are just that. They're just energy in motion. They just want to flow. They just want to be recognized. I can guarantee you, you do not share an emotion that I haven't had, okay? And think about, consider doing a full moon ceremony. It can be as simple as writing down an emotion that you know has come up, that has surfaced. You want to release it. Light a candle and just light the paper on fire. Light the emotion that you want to get rid of or that you want to work through, And just by giving it ritual and ceremony adds to the energy, and you can really be surprised at how much effect this has, what a release it has, okay? So watch that. Also, don't forget to soul scream. That's what I call it. It's just literally sitting with your palms open on your lap, focusing on the breath, bringing in and imagining streaming moonlight or sunlight through the top of your head, and just using that beautiful source energy to stream through and to help to just release any of those emotions that you do not wish to have as part of you, okay? If you want further stuff on the soul, I invite you personally to join me on Soul Space. It's a wonderful private members area where we delve deeper into the soul. We do a lot of intention setting. I interview transformers every month, people that have transformed their lives using the tools that I speak about every Tuesday here with you. And if you really want to gift yourself, consider our transit period guide. Honest to God, you guys, I have it, and I don't leave home without it. I always look to, you know, where the planets are, what favors me in my career, my relationships, and my health. So again, I highly recommend you use it. I do also want to let you know that every year around this time, I take about 6 weeks off to go on sabbatical. I'm going to be going off to do some further studies. I'm going to be going to India. I'm also going to be doing a little R&R meditation and yoga in Costa Rica, but I'll be checking in with you every once in a while just to see how you're doing. I will be back March 6th, and until we meet again, I would love you to share with me, what would you like to see here on Transformational Tuesdays? Because I really do want to be of service to all of you. So if you have any questions, anything that you would like more knowledge in, I would be honored to share what I can. But I will also take this opportunity to let you know you are your own best guide and teacher. So please do consider delving into that part of you that is your best teacher and guide. And for now, I won't say goodbye. I will say I'll see you again soon to the Transformational Tribe that join me every Tuesday. And to you, our new viewers, thank you for tuning in for Transformational Tuesdays. Bye for now. Namaste.